accept the motion.
You're thorough.
The amendments as presented.
I'll second.
I have a motion and a second. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Approved as written with the one exception. Next item. We would like to welcome a new board member, Mr. Mel Ryle. Mel comes with a great deal of experience, I know. He is an appointee from the mayor and a very good one, I might say. So welcome aboard, Mel.
Thank you, Matt. I'm glad to be here and look forward to serving.
Excellent. That said, then I guess we've got elections, correct, for 2022? At this point, I'll open the floor for any discussion on nominations or.
I'll make a motion to keep our same slate. Matt as president, Steve as vice president, and Brandon as secretary.
I'll second that.
Do we have any? Okay, we have a motion and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
All right. Any opposed? Motion carried. The same officers from 2021 will remain for year 2022. Okay, now to the meat of the meeting. The only item on the agenda for today is a public hearing for a variance from developmental standards requested for by Darrell Peterson. Welcome, Darrell. For a vacant property located at the corner of 14th and F in here in Bedford. And Darrell is requesting to place a pole barn-style building on this property. There is presently no principal structure on the property, therefore that's the reason Darrell needs the variance to allow him to construct this pole barn-style structure on this property. He's joining us virtually, therefore we will open the floor to you, Darrell, and if you could give us an idea of what you're looking to do and a few details, please.
Okay, thank you, Brandon. Is everyone able to see my presentation if I share it out? One second.
Yeah, so in your everybody's packet, if you start right here, Darrell provided everybody with this. You just want to go through the presentation and present it, right?
Is that correct?
Pardon me?
Is there a hard copy?
Yes, they do.
Very good, yes.
But I will just walk through it.
Okay. So they're able to follow along with you, so go right ahead when you're ready.
Again, thank you everyone for the opportunity to be down here and keep this brief point and answer the questions you may have. I'll start with slide 2, which is really talking about the opportunity. So I will say that my wife has been
they weren't for sure where, they saw the map that we provided, but they weren't exactly for sure where it was, so I explained to them. But after explaining to them what he was gonna do, where the location was, they didn't have any concerns or problems. And then, all the other property owners that were notified, that were adjoining or adjacent to it, I never received anything, comments back from them as well, so. At this point, everybody seemed to be for it, haven't had any negative.
Does it appear that there are any, are there any issues with regard to where the property is, and the alley, and the road, and as far as, well, I mean, obviously, when he lays the building out, we have all the right setbacks and so forth, so are there any safety issues, or, I mean, I don't buy it, I can't imagine that there would be, I'm just, I'm curious.
Yeah, no, there's not, I provided.
It's a little tight back in there, so.
I provided Daryl limited setbacks prior to him, when we first met, and then, if you, on one of his pages here, he actually added the setbacks down at the bottom of it.
I thought.
And his building, where he placed his building, is met the setbacks, so it, we don't have any issues with that. And being that that's an alley, it's not up close to the front row, so you're not gonna be hindering any vision of any kind. It's in the back, and right behind it is some vacant land. And he actually put a photo of some of the homes that were surrounding there. The one that's in the middle that is really dilapidated, I'm currently in the process of condemning that for a condemnation tear down, so. We're working on cleaning up the property directly behind him anyway, so. But, yeah, everything, he has, everything presented here meets the requirements of what the city requires, except for the thing of the pole barn style building without having any other principal structure on the property, so. That's really the only issue that we have to deal with is that since there's no principal structure home of any kind on there, it's just vacant property. He's going to a pole barn, we just need to give a variance for that if the board allows.
So, if I understand this, even if there was a house currently there, even the one you're trying to condemn, or one similar to that, we wouldn't even be here because he could put the pole barn on it.
Right, it would meet the city code of having a principal structure on the property, but.
Okay, it's just a matter that the lot is vacant at this point, is why it even has to come before us.
That's 100% correct.
Okay.
It would appear to me it's a blessing.
I think it will benefit the neighborhood and values of the properties around there having.
We don't need vacant properties, yeah. We don't need vacant properties, or properties you're having to condemn, we need good properties.
Right.
DC Metals, whom he mentioned might be constructing this, they build fine buildings too.
Oh, they're good.
Yes.
Are there any other questions or concerns, but otherwise I would entertain a motion?
I would, make the motion that we approve this variance as requested.
I have a motion to approve.
I'll second.
I have a second, all in favor of this?
Aye.
Any opposed? The, variance from developmental standards is approved as applied for, sir. Welcome, and, we're looking forward to having you as a full-time resident here one of these days then soon, right?
Yeah, I hope so, I'm a professor up here in Notre Dame, and I told my wife she's living there, but I'm probably working another 5 to 10 years, we'll see. But, I'm definitely a big fan of Bedford, and we love the town, so.
Excellent, excellent.
Well, good luck. Can I just reconnect with you, this, like tomorrow or something?
Yes, I will, I'll send you an email on this, and so you can have verification and all, that everything's good to go, and, you'll be good to go ahead and purchase the property and everything now. But I'll give you verification in form from my office on a, letterhead, so you can have that for whenever you make the purchase to show that, hey, you have to approve by the city of Bedford.
Awesome, thank you, Brandon, thank you, everyone.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
You too.
Are there any other items for discussion of the good order?
No, I just have two reappointment papers to be signed, that I can turn back in to Debbie, and, one's for you, Matt, and one's for Steve. And that's it, so let's need your signature before you leave. Other than that, we've covered everything, we're good to go.
With that, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
Let me make one, I'll make a motion.
Yes, please. I have a motion to adjourn. I have a second, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? They're still gonna stay here, they'll be here by themselves, right?
Well, it's on the books.
All right.